Hi there. My name is Salim Ismail. I'm the CEO of Singularity University, which is not quite about uploading your brain, but the last slide was incredibly telling. This presentation is about how we use accelerating technologies to address global issues, which we think we found a formula for doing. And the title of the talk is really about how we're information enabling everything. We've gone from an idea to global awareness within less than 2 years, and we're now talking to global leaders about this approach. The ability to take new technology and address massive innovation and is coming upon us very quickly. We're clearly coming into a world where our communications are digital rather than analog. For many of you, we're expanding the meaning of what it means to be human. Your memory now exists in your smartphone, not in your own heads, right? And this trend is continuing. As an example, 3D printers used to cost hundreds of thousands of dollars. Today, an $800 3D printer will print 70% of the parts to make the next printer. And we're fabricating steel and food using these technologies. But our global challenges and our grand challenges are also accelerating and also converging. It was noted at our founding conference that the financial crisis, pandemic, swine flu, et cetera, all these problems are rooted in accelerating and exponential factors. And our leadership around the world does not understand that phenomena. We need solutions that can match that disruption and can scale to solve those types of problems. And that's essentially what we study at SU. And what we hope we found a formula for. So what we do is, so step back for a second. I've been working in this area for about a decade. I laid out the first real-time web company called PubSub. I then ran Yahoo's incubator to disrupt the stagnating culture in that company, not that it's a bad company. I built a company called Angstro, and what's interesting, that just got bought by Google last month. What's interesting about Angstro is that the computing power needed to run our algorithms didn't exist when we started the company. If you're building a product or service using today's technology, you may be out of date by the time you get to market. Right? Now, when you do disruptive innovation, you're often combining two very disparate areas and converging them together. Okay? Stem cell researchers are using those 3D printers and pluripotent stem cells to fabricate and create human organs. What we do at SU is we study five accelerating technologies that are doubling in their price performance anywhere from 18 to 30 months. And we focus on these because these are scaling at a doubling rate that can allow us to scale to a global level. We bring together the top thinkers in the world to teach the students about these technologies. Bob Metcalf, Vince Cerf, et cetera, come in. Yossi comes and speaks. And many of the people in this room have come and spoken at SU over the time. We bring them together with the top graduate students from around the world. They're top of their class academically. They've done something entrepreneurial or leadership, and they're passionate about global challenges. We had 1,600 applications for the 80 slots this past summer. Filtering that was a real challenge, and I'll talk about that in a second. The students spent half the time getting a state-of-the-art view of these technologies. What's in the labs today? What's getting commercialized tomorrow? About 160 different speakers over the summer. And then they spend the second half of the summer focused on team projects. And they form teams and their challenges, come up with a product or service that'll impact 1 billion people within 10 years. We want to take that academic rigor and ability to focus and lift it up to the tectonic plate level of a global issue. Okay? We're now 2 years old. We've seen mind-boggling innovation come out of it, and you'll hear from a couple of them later. One of them is cloud computing with microsatellites with an API to do cloud enablement of satellite access. One of the students was a quantum computing expert, is working on quantum computing and nanotech. And we're also piloting new programs to expand our own abilities. To manage 1,600 applications was a real challenge. So we piloted this program with a university in Brazil, where they went to their 10,000 students and said, come up with an idea to impact 1 million people, and you'll get to go to SU for the summer. 230 projects got created in 2 months. And the best guy came and stayed with us over the summer. His idea was around using wikis to enable car sharing and ride sharing, because there's a real traffic problem in Sao Paulo. So we take these students and we seed them back in their home countries with a completely transformed view of the world. Imagine we expand that contest we just did in Jakarta, Mexico City, Shanghai, Tokyo. And we also take leaders, executives, and government leaders through this program. We take them through a week-long course where we give them, again, a state-of-the-art view. And then they look at these 30 or 40 disruptive innovations that are coming down the pike and how might that impact their industries, their companies, their products. It used to take about 20 years to create a $1 billion company. And we're seeing that happen in months today. Clearly, the metabolism of the world is increasing at a rapid pace. And I'd like to leave you with this thought. How will these accelerating technologies impact you? Thank you.